We'll start in just 1 minute.
Okay.
Carlos has a lot of stuff to go through in this presentation. And so while I encourage you to add questions as we go in the chat thread on the right, it's entirely possible that we'll run out of time before we can answer, get through everything and also answer the questions. So in that case, one of the best things you can do is to join the users email group for Apache Royale by going to royale.apache.org and finding the email list and joining it and ask your questions there, and we will be just delighted to answer them.
Yeah.
So we're on the time, and it's a good time to start. I'm Andrew Wetmore. I'm one of the committers for Apache Royale, but I'm just here as the timekeeper, and the main star of the hour is Carlos Rovira.
Thank you, Andrew. I'm Carlos Rovira. I'm PMC of the Apache Royale project, and I want to make your presentation about how to start an Apache Royale project from a blank file. So since it's too much to cover, let's start with this presentation. Okay, while we want to do MVC application in the same way as this site that is well known for many people has done, and this site has many versions of this application done in many languages and frameworks, for example, React, Angular, and many others. So we'll be getting this application. That is the Royale application. This is the final output we want to pursue. And this application, I think, is very good as an example, because it has all these features, and I think that is a lot of features to cover. For example, we cover the UL component set, how to do an MVC application. We'll add the cruise micro framework with beans, bean providers, inversion of control, dependency injection, event handling. We'll customize the styling of the application also. This application use, of course, a core concept in Royale that is strand and beds, and bits. Also view states, list item renders. So how to bind or draw each item in a list, data binding, routing, and finally local storage.
Hey, Carlos, routing is a new term in Royale. It's not the same term that there was in Flex. So what was the equivalent term?
It was called in Flex was deep linking.
Yes.
You were from the Flex days, do we know as deep linking? Okay.
Yeah.
In the new applications, in the new web, we know it as routing. Okay. Okay. This is our journey.
Yes.
There is six steps to cover. So let's go with the first one, that is creating the starter Apache Royale Crux project that we could do with Maven. I must to say that I will use Maven all over this presentation, because I think it's a powerful way to build your projects. But in Royale, we also have another build system like Ant, or you can use the SDK with your IDE. So there are many other options, but I will focus on Maven, on this one. On Maven, we have Maven archetypes. That is a way to create projects from scratch. You will do by using this this instruction on your command line, and as you see, this is for creating a Royale GUI application archetype. We also want to add Crux framework or micro framework that is a library inside Royale. And for that reason, we use this final part of the instruction. No? Here, you can see my input from my sample, but you can change the group ID, the package, and you will take something like this one. This is the project layout we create. In this project layout, this is the part that covers all the code, the application, configuration, events, views, and also we have a SAS configuration, so you can create your styling via SAS, and this will compile to this default CSS files. Okay. Also, we have a template and some config files. The POM file will be the configuration of the Maven project, but we also create these other two for these ones will be for Moonshine IDE, and this other one is for using Visual Studio Code, okay, with just Tinjala extension. Okay, then as we have this project boilerplate, we can just throw the project drag and drop in the Visual Studio Code. I will use for this presentation as well Visual Studio Code, but you can use Moonshine, for example. But as I was usually use code to use in my applications, in my projects, I will use that IDE. Okay, so you can drag and drop the project folder to the Visual Studio Code, and you will get the project open in that IDE, and you can just press Command Shift plus B to build with Maven. Okay, you will get some options to build, but you can choose with Maven to get this project compiled. At the moment, you will only get Hello Crux because the project is already empty. So let's go to laying out or of the interface. And what we want to do is put all the pieces of visual pieces inside the application. Okay. So the first one is to use a root main app application file that will be called app.mxml. And this file will have the application and the Crux configuration and an initial view. Okay, this file used to be very typical in most of the applications, so that will be usually the same always. Okay, we also have here in this part some instructions to load the CSS or the styles. Okay, as I say, this always used to be the same. In the Crux, we used to put the packages for events and from views. So Crux knows when to search for events and for views. And this one will be the view, because in Royale we have the application is decoupled from the view. Let's go from the to the view part, and here we have the main view, and we'll be using some components from the part to mimic the to-do MVC list application that you can show in the todomvc.org site. So for that, to make that happen, we use some HTML components like HTML section, like a H1, a header, and then we will fill it with some GUI components. Then we will want to do the header part that is composed but by a text input and a toggle button. In that part, since we want those components to be laid out absolutely, we'll use for that a group. A group is a container where we want to that we use when we want to have absolute positioning. Okay, so we can put there inside a text input and the toggle button. As you can see, we use as well a text prompt bit that is some of the parts that is not baked in the own text input, but we want to use only when we want to use a text prompt in a text input. And for the text toggle button, we have a material icon that is instead is a component that we add to the icon attribute. Then for the footer bar, that is the last part of the screen, we'll have a bar row that is a container that lays out the things, the components horizontally, and we'll be using states. View states is an interesting part in Royale, as it was in Flex, where we can define different view states and give it a name. With those names, then we can refer in other parts of the view, so we can say change the behavior of that components depending on the state. If you, as you can see, we are using here a dot notation to select or to refer to some of the states defined above. So when I using select dot all true, the toggle button will be set to true when we are in the state all. So we have to put the rest of the options here, select dot attack, select dot complete to configure all the view states. Finally, we can take all these parts and add to the view we already set up in the first screen, in the first slide, getting all the parts of the application layout, all the visual parts of the application layout. Okay, so in the header, we'll add the to-do header that will be this part. Then the footer will be in the last part, and this what you can see here. And finally, for the list part, we'll use a data container. We are using a data container here because we don't want a list visual layout, just want to lay out some data items, and don't need for example key control or don't want focus or any other parts that we want when we use a list. So data container is a component that uses a data provider to load items, data items, but visually is less, we have less things and we only is usually for layout that that items, okay? So with those three parts, we have the visual layouts all set up. So we can go to setting up the MVC. As you probably will know what is a MVC model view controller application, basically when, for example, we click a button, the user click a button, it sends an event. The controller manipulates that event and usually operates over the model. Then the model change and we use data binding to update the view. So the user finally can see how the application was changed. So the model, thanks to the Crux micro framework, can be just a basic class. As you can see, it's a normal class. It's not extending or implementing anything. It's just a class with some variables that we want to store some data. Usually are strings, booleans, and in this case, in this application, since we have a to-do list, is an array list and array list view that are some classes in Royale that uses to define lists. In Flex, we had array collection, if you remember. As well, one important thing is that we are using bindable as a metadata because we want this class to be used for data binding in the application. Then each data item, we use in the application is to do VO that has all the data we want to store. For example, the description in this label or the completion state of the to-do item. As well, this is marked as bindable. Then we have event handling. This is a application level event that we use to send events across the application. In this event, we want to fill with a to-do VO, and we want to mark it as bubble. We will see right now, later in the presentation, what bubbles mean. Okay. Then we have the controller. That is the part of the application that holds all global actions. Here we will have methods like this, marked with event handler, that will be able to react to all the actions that we want to define in the application. Again, this is having in Crux and is again another class without any other boilerplate or extending any other thing. One final thing I want to say is that, as you can see, in the controller, we are operating on the model variable, in this case, all items, to change a model in the controller, and this will make the view change through data binding. Finally, to glue all things with Crux, we need to use the parts defined as bins. For that, we use the bins MXML in the config folder already set up when we create the application. And this is a bin provider. Bin provider is a class in the Cruise framework that is in charge of create all the bins. Instantiate the to-do model, the to-do controller, and it puts available to the rest of the application. In fact, when you in the to-do controller, now we can inject this to-do model in the controller, and the application, when loads, will take the bin in the bin provider and use in that class. This is done through the inject metadata, and is the magic that Crux make behind the scenes by injecting the instance of the class created at the startup in the controller.
Just a note, we're halfway done.
Okay. Adding the to-do item will be the next thing we want to cover, and is how to set up the pieces of the interaction for to add one single item to the list. Just one single item for now. So we want to use the to-do header and the to-do on the text input. And when we hit enter in the text input, we want to generate a series of actions. So first, we'll use to-do event. We need to add this action to this file, since groups will need to know all the constants in this to-do event to register and to then we'll be able to use the events or react to the events. Okay. Then in the to-do header, we'll have an enter event, and this event will use to take the text inside the test input, and if there is some test, we will create an application level event that with a to-do BO with the text we have in the test input. Then it will be dispatched to the application as a to-do event of type add to-do item with the piece of info we already filled. Okay. Finally, we'll be cleaning the text input at the end of this method. As we are bubbling this event, we are hitting enter. The enter was calling the add item method, and we create a to-do event that is bubbling all through the document object model of this application until reach the application level. In that way, Crux is able to use that event and will check if we have some class with an event handler that is could react to the add to do item. As we create in the to-do controller this function, Crux knows that it can handle that event, and it will do. So we'll use the all items array list to add one item, and it's the one we created from the list. And finally, we'll be updating the interface. If we want to use some server contact, in this case, it's not the case. We can use a service helper to call to make some call to the server, and handle the result or the file in case it fails. Okay, this will be the code we use in the controller to change the model variables. As you can see here, all our model variables that are changing to update all the application variables in a model in the right way. So as we change all these variables in the model, this will trigger the data binding, and in that way we'll be updating the views. Here in the in this part, we'll see how to data binding is used. So in a view, we must to first inject the to-do model. As we do again before, we must to inject the to-do model. And in that way, we have the instance of the model, of the application level model, available in the view. And then we can use data binding in this way with the curly braces, as we did in Flex, to bind the data provider of the data container to this array list. So in that way, we are ensuring that as items are loaded or removed from the or changed in this array list, the data container will always be updated to get the latest all the information we want represent and keep up to date the application. One important thing we must to do in Royale is to add this bit, that is container data binding, because in Royale we don't have the functionality like data binding baked in all components. We need to add this functionality to the component to make it able to use data binding. This is important because this is one of the things we promote in Royale, since we want this framework to be very performant and quick. And so we are not adding functionality that we don't need all the time. So this is the pay-as-you-go concept that we already saw in Andrew's talk or in Alina's talk. Okay, we are going to draw each list item because until now we have a data container that is using the data, but if we left in this way, this list will be always showing just a label because the default item renderer of the data container is just showing a label. But we want this data container shows a better representation, and we want a green checkbox like here with a label also, but with a label with a good font and size. Also, if we complete some of the items we want to the label to be a strike, and we also want to be able to edit by double clicking the item renderer. Okay, so we'll be defining an item renderer, and we can configure that code in two ways. We can use CSS in this way by creating in CSS this rule and adding as a class name, or we can use mxmodel to add the item renderer directly as a property in the data container. Then we have data renderer itself that is defined in this way. We are all, I am just adding just a few code because this file is large than I was representing. But then you can see the code, the final code in the sample already in the Apache Royale repository. Okay, as we are using a GUL data container here, we want to extend from list item renderer, and we'll be using again states at that level, and adding for the states a simple state implementation that is the bit that we need to add the view state functionality. Also, we want to add data binding to this item renderer. We want the items layout to be horizontal in this item too. And finally, we'll be adding, we'll be removing the default padding because the padding defined in this item renderer is by default 8 pixels, but we want 0 pixels in this item.
10 minutes to go.
Okay. Then here we have checkbox, label, text input, and equal button. The checkbox is the green the green checkbox that we will need to change its representation to green and bigger. Also, we have the label, the text input when we want to edit, and an icon button when we want to destroy the this item. Then go to the final touches of this application, that is styling, storage, and routing. In GUL, we have the GUL theme, that is the GUL theme is the main master theme in GUL, and we use it to to create the look and feel of the application. We have a default look and feel, and we can change the styling defined in that GUL theme. Then we have all over GUL SASS language to create the styling, because this is not this is optional, but recommended, because for the same reason we want to use ActionScript 3 over JavaScript, because we want more organization and more and be have more control over the code we are creating. Here is some of the files or the rule definition we are changing. For example, here the GUL button this is the default styling, but we want to get this, or this. These are all buttons in the to-do MVC application. And for this reason, we are changing in this way, changing via SAS the definitions. In Royale, we are having we have a compiler, and when we compile these rules, this will take precedence over the ones in the framework. So when we create a border definition, we are the compiler is using this border definition and not the one in the GUL. So this way we can have our definition and not the one in GUL. Also, we can use CSS to add in this way, as we saw, bits to the via CSS. Now, for saving data, we can use local storage. Local storage is a way to store in the browser's data, and we will use AMF, that is a protocol that comes from Flash and Flex, and it's very efficient and even better than JSON, because in JSON we will need to add methods to encode and decode each item we want to create for any application. So if, for any object, we need to define this encoding and decoding methods. Even but in AMF, you don't need to do any of that. This is the way we use to create to inject the local storage. We have simple methods, one for get the item store and other to set the item store. We are using this method to save all the items at once and to retrieve all the items at once. And we are using, again, the injecting cruise way to get the bin in the bins MXML, to get the bins that is in charge of storing and retrieving the data. One more thing you need is to add the remote class, okay, because to make the AMF magic works, and don't forget to add a class alias bit to the main application. This will be the way we use in the delegate to set the item store, okay? And this is the way we configure in the bins MXML the local storage delegate and the AMF storage bin. Finally, routing. Routing is as we have a SPA application, a single page application, all happens in the same page. So we could want to have the browser address updated with the state of the application. In this way, we have again this done with bits, and we have a router bit with different components. In this case, we are using route to state and route little title lookup to configure this routing. We are using these components in a way that will take the view states to get the information we need to change the state in the browser. And that's all. I think with this faster you know Apache Royale as Neo in Matrix, okay? So don't know if we can have some questions, maybe?
We just have a couple of minutes, but sure, if we have, if anyone has some questions, please type them in the chat
okay.
Stream. And
I go very quick in the presentation, but it's many things to cover. So you can understand me that it's very difficult for an application that has so many things. I think we cover all except modules. So with the example in to-do MVC, we have all things we can do in Royale in an application. Maybe modules and go to the server, for example, this with an HTTP service or a remote object. But it's a good application, I think, to learn and to know how Royale works.
It's very impressive. And to have the source code is available.
Yeah, the source code is for you to use. I don't have a hand right now, but we will share. Because I already posted in Twitter account of Royale. We have in many threads in the Royale mailing list, so people can can take it from there.
Super.
I think there is no question.
No, people are just astonished. Their brains are filled up
are melting.
with to-do items.
Okay. Dan Bernard thinks, I think he wants to something.
Yeah, I think if there are no questions, we can. Carlos, thank you very, very much.
Thank you all.
Full and thorough. And Daniel is very smart. And Corey.
Thank you.
And if to learn more, come to royale.apache.org and engage with us, help us grow Apache Royale, see what you can do with it.
Okay. So
thank you, Mike.
Thank you, and bye. More and more with the G-Wall. Okay.
See you soon. Bye-bye.